Welcome to the Industry Knowledge Exchange Conclave brought to you by CNBC TV 18 in partnership with SAP. This virtual summit is focused around understanding the role of technology and innovation in the life sciences industry and why building tech-powered customer centricity is imperative in today's times. The session will begin with a keynote speech followed by interesting panel discussions on the new age CFOs, which are the drivers of digital transformation and digital imperatives for future-ready pharma companies.
The pandemic has disrupted critical structures within every industry, including the pharma industry. And this has actually accelerated or catalyzed an acceleration of digital transformation, which has, of course, dramatically changed the conventional pre-COVID paradigm. I would say that the greatest impact of this digital disruption or digital acceleration has been in the area of regulatory processes. You can see that this actually has seen the delivery of a vaccine from lab to market within less than a year, which was unheard of, unprecedented.
Well, welcome to this conversation. In the current dynamic business environment, it has become imperative for executives in the life sciences segment to be experts in many disciplines. The evolving role of the CFO is not just confined to numbers and bottom line risk manager, but it has expanded to be that of an integral contributor to the overall corporate strategy. They are now a close partner to the CEO. While growth of the CFO's role is not specific to life sciences, the technical and innovative nature of the industry with an added layer of regulatory burden makes the requirements here far more challenging than other sectors. Over the course of the next 45 odd minutes, we will be discussing health technology and how things have actually changed post-COVID and the way forward. So to join us this afternoon, we have Ramesh Swaminathan of Lupin, Nitin Parekh of Zydus Cadila, Kedar Upadhyay of Cipla, Mantiran Chauhan of SAP, and Ravi Kumar of Loris Labs. Welcome to the conversation, everybody. How are we placed as compared to the entire globe when it comes to technology per se? I'm not talking about adaptation and acceleration, but I'm talking about where we are placed when it comes to technology in healthcare vis-a-vis our global peers. Ramesh.
Indian pharma has always been all about affordable care at very high quality. So we do all that it takes to reduce costs, increase productivity and quality. Conventionally, we have used a host of measures to actually reduce costs. And that could range from actually routes to synthesis to procurement excellence. And of course, a keen eye on, in fact, the SG&A costs, productivity of the sales force, productivity of R&D and the like. But we are now getting on to even more contemporary things, which is essentially looking at smart factories. You have digital measures along the entire value chain. You're also getting into more contemporary technology in terms of continuous manufacture, 3D printing. There's so many things which are evolving today. Whilst, of course, on the sales and distribution front and the marketing front, we're growing closer to the customer. You know, healthcare is moving away from hospitals onto the homes. And there is this is the era where you could talk about mass customization, mass personalization and the like. So digital analytics is going to be extremely important.
Okay. Mr. Parekh, would you agree that technology has now become an imperative part post-COVID? And when you do make the budgets going forward, or maybe even for FY23, I'm sure you're already working on it, you do allocate much more when it comes to technology vis-a-vis pre-COVID.
Yeah, I certainly agree that larger allocation from IT is now being done for various digital initiatives. COVID has perhaps, as other panel members mentioned, expedited this process in terms of working from home and use of various technology and tools, more importance of cybersecurity also gaining. But certainly, role played by CFOs in terms of making management convinced about the return on investment of digital initiative is very important. in most large companies, including Zydus, CFOs also are in charge of IT. Like in Zydus, I handle IT, finance, and legal functions. So I have a role to play in terms of, you know, making out a convincing case. At the same time, I must mention that some of the digital initiatives would be having a little long-term horizon, and calculation of payback period is not very easy. So somewhere the leap of faith approach will also need to play. And it's a role of CFOs to, you know, make that convincing case to the management that here, you know, there is a prima facie evidence that this would be the interest of the organization, though monetary calculations may or may not be sensible at times. But if it is making a positive sense that the outcomes are likely to help the organization, management will have to go for that.
Okay, all right, that point is taken. Mr. Kumar Rao, what are your thoughts in terms of where India stands post-COVID in terms of embracing digitization as well as technology? Have CFOs become much more open to adopting a new normal?
Yeah, BCP, we always looked at it as a theory before. COVID taught us a practical without having any notice, without any past experience. So this is, we learned a lot during the COVID time, and then I think digitalization will be advanced, especially in the pharma, where in the pharma, especially in the small companies and medium companies, where they're on the digitalization, there is a long way to go. And so maybe there are a lot of scope for small and medium companies to go for even a mini ERPs, maybe a lot of digitalization. In fact, what we have to do is, because now the paperless, everyone think that the paperless is the best one, but where we are actually, you know, there is a lot of scope in the quality control, as some of the my previous speakers were talking about, like, you know, there is a very huge scope for the quality control and then the manufacturing. Of course, manufacturing, there is excellent equipment, but those equipment data has to be captured and analyzed, and then you have to use the different tools. So there is a lot of scope, and but of course challenges too. Now these days, because we are going for more and more digitalization, there is a huge challenges to safeguard the data. You have to protect data. Security become in data security become a very concern. Now companies not only looking for a digitalization, but also looking for the safeguarding the information, and then, you know, without having any cyber threats.
Okay, all right. Yes, that's an important point, that security becomes one of the key points to look at when it comes to progression in terms of technology as well. But Mankaran, coming to you, you know, CFOs have played a crucial role in the process of digitization. How will they probably further enable and keep the momentum of this transformation, according to you?
I think that's a great question, Ekta. And like others have said, I think COVID has certainly been that honeymoon period for digital initiatives, and CFOs have absolutely taken the lead in that transforming their organization focus. And they've been very focused on getting the process efficiencies and improvements at the low cost, which has really been the, you know, which has been the focus on how do we get that while we unlock that accelerated business growth. So clearly, we're seeing that the CFOs are taking a more holistic approach towards digitization, right? I mean, some of you spoke about IT rolling up to finance. So the holistic approach is coming into play for on how do we fast track that profitable result that the enterprise is also really, you know, betting on. If you look at the misconception that people have is that digital transformation is all about technology. On the contrary, it's all about getting the combination of technology, people, you know, the financial transformation, somebody just mentioned paperless or security, all of it combined together is really where the transformation will happen. You know, for a moment, if I could talk about successful digital native businesses, let's talk about maybe an Ola or a Flipkart or a Byju's. These are stories of transforming business models that have been powered by financial engineering. And these companies, if you look at it, have invested millions or even billions of dollars. They've run losses for several years. They've invested in changing our habits so that we could get new ways of consuming products and services. And, you know, that extraordinary result that has come at an inflection point. And that's the wave of change that's being driven by that emergence of new technologies and service models that can really drive that efficiency and intelligence in critical financial processes. And while CFOs are getting their organization digitally enabled, there are roadblocks, there are some, challenges. And one of the challenges is really this, how do we get that improved return on digital investments and balance that with tangible business objects, objectives. While especially I think for industries like e-commerce or banking or education, these are on forefront for adopting digital measures. Pharmaceutical companies have traditionally run a little behind in the race. And that's, I think, where the challenge is on how do we bring that agility and flexibility of cloud, for healthcare organizations. So I think if you look forward, despite all the challenges in the past, CFOs are focused on how do they get that advantage of achieving growth via digital. And they can help by really looking at the real-time analytics to make informed decisions or by adopting a very capital allocation model, which is focused on flexibility in resource allocation, especially around the digital initiatives like that.
Okay, that biggest opportunity and biggest challenge.
I think the biggest opportunity for us is this vibrant community of startup and young innovative minds. I get, as part of my role, I get to interact and talk to many of them, and I'm amazed with what they want to do, what they aspire for, the level of experimentation and the sheer energy of trying several things, and there will be experiments. Some of them will fail, but many of them will succeed in my view. And as I said, I think we have crossed quite a bit of journey in the last 3 years, and this COVID has given a tremendous fillip. So I'm quite confident that, next 2 years is going to be phenomenally different. A lot of value creation will happen. A lot of newer ways of running our business will come up. And maybe on a completely different note, there are very few parallels of Cowin or Aarogya Setu app in the world, actually.
Thank you very much for joining in on this conversation. It's been very insightful, and I'm sure we're going to power ahead when it comes to technology and transformation. Thank you very much. Well, the wave of digital disruption disrupted every sector, including life sciences, really pushing the boundary in the healthcare sector and changing the way care, in fact, is provided. Organizations in the industry today have to build new technology forward strategies to compete with the flexibility and speed of digital natives. To achieve the digital goals, in fact, companies have elevated their digital agenda and have started creating a laundry list of digital use cases. As the sophistication of information technology progresses, the role of CIOs also comes into focus. So to discuss this and more, and how exactly technology is going to progress in the pharmaceutical space 3 to 5 years hence, we have an esteemed panel of guests with us: Mr. Saini of Lupin Limited, Mr. Digumarthy of Loris Labs, Ritu Ranade of SAP, Mukesh J of Alembic Pharma, and Srinivas Reddy of Granules, as well as Mr. Anjani Kumar of Stripe. Welcome to the conversation. Anjani, if you could just explain to us, how exactly have you managed to adopt your technology post-COVID? What were your key learnings, and what do you think were your key challenges as well?
So digital transformation has been in our journey for quite some time. We started something called Path to Digital program two years back. With the COVID coming in, definitely we had to relook, because some of the program needed to be accelerated because of the digitization, like digitization of logbooks, where you don't have paper entries. Those were definitely accelerated. There were fewer touch points wherever we could do fewer touch points. Some of the things, if they could be done remotely, reviewed remotely. So those kind of systems were accelerated for sure. Then next one, which was very, very important, is data part. Once you digitize, you look at how do you harvest the data? And that is another area. And once you harvest the data, people could do review the things remotely. People could not everybody need to be there on the same place in the factories. So that's another area which is very related to COVID. These were the two areas where we accelerated more from the data and digitization perspective in manufacturing side.
All right, Ritu, I just wanted to come to you with regards to what the latest trends might be in terms of digital transformation being adopted by pharma companies globally?
There are major observations in this industry, and I would just narrate some highlights or some key points as to what we are observing as a trend setting. In the pharmaceutical industry, majorly, the digital transformation is very, very critical. We are seeing organizations focus on cost effectiveness, improved patient care, create larger transparency and improve production time as well, right? This is one of the major focus areas. And if you see the underlying area, the underlying bit which is happening is how do you improve or enable pharmaceutical businesses to manufacture counterfeit proof medication, which is another trend or which is another area which is becoming highly important. From a technology point of view, moving to cloud purely from an operational efficiency is also a focus area for a lot of large pharmaceutical organizations, which we have observed. They are taking it not as a transformation, but a must-have. There's a lot of data in their network, in their devices, how to collaborate, how to get this data together and make it scalable on a platform. It has been a major, major trend.
Mr. Mukesh, what are your thoughts and what has been the transition according to you?
What cloud is providing for the pharma companies, it gives scalability and mobility and give the access from anywhere. So redundancy to give the access from the one locations or particular locations is gone if you move the data on cloud. So definitely we are also moving and slowly moving on that part because of the certain restrictions or that certain rules that we have to follow. So we cannot move all the data immediately on cloud, but definitely that is on our path that we have to move the data on cloud.
Mr. Reddy, in your experience, how has COVID probably helped in terms of acceleration of digitization according to you?
So according to me, and actually speaking, you know, the digitalization or digital transformation is already there in the industry for several years. The only thing is the COVID has accelerated the requirement of the digitalization. Most important thing is, you know, when we especially talk about pharmaceutical industry, where the drug manufacturing units, which are, you know, typically placed in remote areas, right? So internet availability is one of the major challenge what we normally see on a day-to-day when you are accessing. But apart from that, the COVID has helped us a lot to accelerate and multiply our systems requirement and implement various systems where we can have online integrations, like whether it is a QMS or SAP or plant automations or some kind of IT/OT technologies. So that has significantly increased.
But Mr. Seni, in your opinion, where would you probably place India when it comes to digital adoption, even post-COVID, as compared to your global peers?
If you to look at the adoption of digital post-COVID era, I think India would be in one of the top three countries. It would not be wrong to say that it could be even the leading in digital adoption across the globe. But we are one of the leading countries, definitely. If you've seen a lot of initiative across the pharma as a sector, I believe almost every company is moving into adopting digital in almost everything. We have been to multiple, have multiple discussions with people in this segment. Almost everyone has gone for remote audit. Almost everyone has started an RPA journey, robotic process automation journey, right? And it's just taking pace, faster and faster pace. I believe would rate in top three, globally in the digital adoption.
But Mr. Digumarti, in your sense, what do you think would probably be the need of the hour when it comes to pharmaceutical companies and digitization?
So one is on the security aspect, and the other is on the automation. Which includes even the artificial intelligence and machine learning. So using them, we can create the analytics dashboards, which will help initiating the next potential business growth and issues, and accordingly we can mitigate them, number one. Number two, on the security aspect, as you know, the pharma has been attacked by various hackers of late. So a lot of security controls, we have to ensure our data are safe, we need to protect our data and ensure we mitigate all the ransomware or malwares that come into our network. So there are a lot of application services that has come into picture of late, and most of the pharma companies and peers with whom I have interacted, of late we are absorbing those technologies and along with the automation piece.
Okay, well, that was a very insightful conversation that yes, India is progressing when it comes to adoption of technology in healthcare, but maybe there could be some amount of time before we actually get there, a possible horizon of 3 to 5 years. Thank you very much, Ritu, as well as the rest for joining in to this conversation today.